Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today we don't have very many standard updates, so most of the video will be spent in Boca Chica with infrastructure and Starship development. Let's head straight in and get up to date. To start this video, here's a shot of the inside of Crew Dragon Resilience. Mike Hopkins, the capsule commander, has been sleeping inside the Dragon. This is due to a lack of sleeping pods aboard the International Space Station currently. Recently, with Starlink 15, Falcon 9 booster B1049 made history by becoming the first to fly and land 7 times. This very scorched machine returned to port on Saturday to be recovered, inspected, refurbished and reflown for the 8th time. I can't wait to see how this booster will look after 10 or more launches. With these bits of information covered, let's see what's up in Boca Chica. First up, we have the latest view of the work going on with the new bunker-style structures currently under development at the orbital launch pad. Around the launch area, SpaceX have been constructing a new wall of shipping containers. You can see that it's been progressing as more of the area becomes hidden. Mary got some great footage of the landing pad area where they've recently been doing work. Hopefully soon we'll see the first full-size Starship SN8 sitting on here. Engineers have also been doing some further work atop Starhopper with them working on one of its antennas. Here's a cool view of the suborbital pad area with the mount at pad A with SN8 and the pad B mount as well. Over in the production area, an interesting new delivery was spotted with something covered up. Now we have some pieces of Starship that have been seen, starting with another new delivery. Here we have a new thrust puck as well as pipes, possibly for downcomers, seen on a trailer. Not long ago we saw a new nose cone tip sitting out in the yard with a LOX header tank. I believe this is the same nose cone tip and engineers appear to have been working on it some more. In terms of noses, we also have the new nose cone under construction in the fabrication tent. Another new tapered nose cone segment which was outside was also moved for when they need to stack it. Spotted being worked on is SN5, however they've only been removing the no longer needed heat shield tiles. Some aerosurface covers for a future Starship prototype have been seen sitting out in the yard. In place to make history is the Starship SN8 prototype currently standing tall on the Pad A suborbital mount. SpaceX recently performed the fourth static fire for this Starship earlier in the week. This vehicle has also continued to undergo preparations for the upcoming 15km flight. Taking another look at the road and beach closures which are unchanged, we still have Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. So I was hoping that tomorrow we could expect to see this thing lift off. However, Michael Baylor tweeted that there is still no temporary flight restriction for the 15km flight. He says, "I understand that the target launch date is now later in the week. After SN8 has done its thing, SN9 might head out to the pad to begin testing. You can see that the nose cone which was moved into the high bay has now been lifted and stacked with the tank. So they are now working on getting everything hooked up so this prototype can be rolled out for some tests. If SN8 survives, I imagine that the plan will be to fly SN9 to a higher altitude. Just a little bit of SN14 to throw in here, just to the right of the nose cone tip we saw earlier is a leg skirt. That's apparently for the SN14 prototype. Spotted for the first time not long ago, we have SN15 with the common dome section hooked up to a crane. It was attached to the flipping mechanism so it could be rotated. Then they flip this stack into the correct orientation as they progress with this serial number. Also for SN15, we have another new section seen being moved with this nose cone ring stack. It was moved near to where the super heavy barrel sections are sitting. Talking about super heavy, stacking seems to have slowed down, possibly due to SN9 stacking. However, this stack labelled aft quad number 2 was seen outside and I don't remember seeing this before. The very final thing to show is another version of the Starship super heavy overview thanks to Brendan Lewis. It's so cool to see these Starships coming together at such pace. These updates wouldn't be possible without the incredible Mary or Boca Chica gal going out all day every day to film, so thank you. Also, thank you to the incredible NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes to bring us awesome space coverage. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.